Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host, live here in Austin on this Friday, November 21st, 2014. Paul Joseph Watson is going to be co-hosting with me from the UK. We've got some interesting guests today. We've got Paul Craig Roberts is going to be talking to us about some international issues and the economy. And we have a guest, Eric Rush, author of the book, Negrophilia, From Slave Block to Pedestal. That's an important thing to look at right now as we're waiting for this verdict in Ferguson. One of the articles that we have on InfoWars right now, rioters to target whites, quote, "You will never be safe, not you, not your children." See, that's the issue. The issue is what started out, and we've seen this over and over again, not just in Ferguson, but in so many places. I remember when this first broke as news, it was yet another case of the police shooting somebody when their life was not in danger. I still believe that's the case. Yet you have this issue of an epidemic of police violence. Many people have spoken out on it. We're going to have a quote from Frank Serpico. I'm sure many of you, pretty much all of you, know him from the movie Serpico. But he spoke out and said that essentially we've moved from the biggest problem being corruption when he was in New York, essentially a corruption that came on by the war on drugs. That kind of prohibition always corrupts the police. But he says we've moved on from that, and now the issue really is this out-of-control, unchecked police violence. But, of course, they were able to take what could have been a thoughtful look at the situation, something that both sides could come together on, white and black could take a look at this, and see that although this is something that is affecting black people more than it is white people, it is affecting everybody now. This is a true epidemic. They just had in the Albuquerque Police Department a course that's being put out on killology. We see them talking about puppycide because they're killing so many dogs. They're killing everyone. And all they have to do is say, "I feel that I was threatened," and they're given a pass. We could have a real discussion about how we get control of our government, get control of the police, but instead, they turned it into a racial paradigm, trying to turn it into a race war. And now we see also that they're reinforcing the fear of the police. The police have been told for a long time by Homeland Security, by the federal government, they've been told that they're in a war, that they need to fight back, that they're going to have to shoot first and keep shooting. And all this does is underscore that. This is going to basically further entrench this kind of war mentality when they're threatening the police, saying, "We're going to come to your house. We're going to come and get you." That's not the right way to approach this. We need to get control of the police. There needs to be accountability. Frank Serpico had some really good points to make in the Politico article. Would love to get him on. He's been on with Alex Jones many times. He's difficult to find. But that's the real issue. But instead, they're going to make it into a race war. So we have reporters that are there on the scene. Jakari Jackson, Joe Biggs are going to be giving us updates on what is happening, the threats, the buildup, and anticipation of today, the grand jury meeting. We believe that they're going to, everyone believes that they're going to come across with their verdict today. And, of course, Darren Wilson, the police officer who did the shooting, is going to possibly resign. I guess that's going to be their olive branch of peace that they're going to make out there. But it's not really, I think, going to address the problem. They let this thing run for a very long time before they brought out any evidence that would justify what he did. I think that was a deliberate effort by the government to move this into a race war. So we're going to be talking to our reporters there in Ferguson. And as I said, we're going to be talking to Eric Rush on Negrophilia. Now, there's a lot of reactions today to Obama's amnesty speech yesterday. We're going to be talking about the reactions that people had to that. And we're going to talk about what that really means. Stay with us. We'll be right back with Paul Joseph Watson from the UK.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
The experts are clear. Sunlight, purified water, healthy non-GMO food, and having a good attitude is essential to a healthy immune system. But I go further with Super Nascent Iodine X2 from InfoWarsLife.com. 50% stronger than our original and revolutionary Nascent Iodine formula, coming from a deep earth crystal source that no other supplier has. Most other forms of iodine come from seaweed in areas plagued by Fukushima and other contaminants. Not our iodine. It comes from over 200 million year old crystal salt deposits and is tested and proven to be completely pure. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. See the informational videos, read the information they're compiled, and for a limited time, when you use promo code NOW at checkout, you get an additional 5% off the entire family of InfoWarsLife.com products. Secure your Survival Shield X2 today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139.
Crashing through the lies and disinformation, it's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight in Austin, joined by Paul Joseph Watson in the UK. Now, of course, last night was the amnesty speech that Obama gave, giving people permission to stay. Not necessarily making them citizens, but basically giving them the right to stay as long as they wish. And we've seen how this works out in many cases. We've had a measure in Illinois to allow people who aren't citizens to vote. We know that with the deferred action that was done for children, the DACA program, he allowed people up to the age of 31 to stay. And not only that, but to get free education benefits, to go to universities with a in-state tuition, in many cases a full ride. I mean, we're the ones who are paying for this. I look at one of the immigration groups, CASA, they say was a major immigrant rights group that was based in Maryland and Virginia. They were planning three screening parties last night to watch this announcement. When I looked at that, CASA, you know, it's like mi casa, su casa, you know, my house is your house, except it's the other way around, isn't it? They're essentially saying to the American people, su casa, mi casa, your house is my house. I'm coming to live with you, and there's nothing you're going to do about it. And that's essentially what Obama has done for them. Paul, they're saying that it's 11 million people that they believe are possibly here illegally at this point, and they're only going to extend legal status to half of those people. Who's counting these people? They don't have any idea how many people are here. He's created a massive entitlement program as well as incentivizing further illegal immigration.
Well, exactly. I mean, they always underplay the numbers that are most embarrassing to them. They underplay the jobs numbers on a routine basis. So who knows how many illegals are here? But as you said, they had the screening parties, the celebrations in the Mexican restaurants. And what they're all saying, the message is, this is only the beginning. The fight begins here. They want the welfare.
Yeah.
They want the medical benefits.
Yeah.
And they want the voting rights. This is only the start, David.
Oh, yeah. Of course, it only begins here. We've been through all this before. We saw this back when Reagan did it in 1986. And that was going to be just allow the people who are already here to stay. They've got ties here. So just grant them the ability to stay. We'll fix the border here. We won't have any more illegal immigration. And yet it's continued to rise and unabated, actually accelerating. If you incentivize people coming here, and that's what Obama did with DACA, that's what he's doing with this announcement, you're going to get more of that. You're not going to get less of it.
Well, exactly. And then, you know, there's the constitutional perspective, which is key as far as I'm concerned. I think Pat Buchanan nailed it in his article today. He said future presidents will cite the Obama precedent. We have just taken a monumental step away from republicanism towards Caesarism.
Yes. So
this is ruled by diktat, the rejection of which sparked the American Revolution. But David, I mean, that revolution is not going to be led by the Republican leadership, because we know already they've come out with their lukewarm response against it, as we predicted yesterday.
Yes.
And it's encapsulated in a Washington Post article, which talks about how Boehner and McConnell are more concerned over the party's brand than anything else. They're concerned about having a stable period of GOP governance. And this is summed up in a quote by Peter King out of New York, a Republican, particularly illustrative of the rhino Republican rhetoric that we're seeing. He said, it's the first real challenge for Boehner and McConnell together. They'd like to wipe the slate clean for when they start up next year with this situation behind us. And what he's talking about is eliminating the, quote, insurgent Tea Party Republicans, shunning them to the side, restricting their influence on the party, and dropping any opposition to Obama's executive amnesty. So the leadership of the Republican Party across the board will do absolutely nothing to stop this train wreck and to reverse what Obama has wrought on the country over the past 6 years.
Oh, absolutely. They want this badly. This is for the U.S. Chamber of Commerce. This is for the large companies that want to have competition for blue-collar workers, for people at the bottom end of the scale. Those are the people who have traditionally been core to the Democrat Party. They're the ones that Obama has really betrayed. But the Republicans are betraying the country. The Republicans themselves, the Republican leadership, is betraying the Constitution. Now, we do have some Republicans who are speaking out on it. Remains to be seen what they're going to do. Louis Gohmert said, the president has said, well, Congress didn't act. I waited 6 years, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. And he said, that's outrageous. And it is. We have a system of checks and balances. We have a constitutional system. We have rule of law. Look at how many things, for example, Ronald Reagan, who was up against Democrats' majority in both houses of Congress, a lot of things that he wanted to do that they blocked him on. And he didn't say, well, you know, I waited for 6 months or I waited for 6 years and you didn't do what I wanted to do. So I'm just going to sign a bill and make it happen on my own without you. I mean, he didn't do that in spite of what they're saying about the amnesty. There was a really good article that really kind of laid that out. There's been a lot of back and forth between the left and right. AP put out a story earlier this week saying that, well, you know, both Reagan and Bush did exactly the same thing that Obama's doing. No, they didn't at all. This is a good analysis, Paul, that I saw on the Powerline blog. Basically, he got into some of the details of it. The Simpson-Mazzoli Act, the Immigration Reform and Control Act of 1986, required Reagan, the president, to adjust the status of certain illegal immigrants to the category of, quote, alien lawfully admitted for temporary residence. It also authorized the attorney general to allow other illegal immigrants who did not qualify for amnesty to remain in the U.S. if they needed to, quote, assure family unity. So the small number of people that was adjusted by Reagan later on was in compliance with that. And he said they even quoted it in their article, in their order, rather. They said the administration made it clear it was carrying out the direction of Congress. It even cited the section of law